गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. लास्ट टाइम वी डिड वी हैड स्टार्टेड विथ हार्वेस्टिंग. नाउ आई जस्ट क्विकली रिवाइज व्हाट इज हार्वेस्टिंग. द कटिंग ऑफ क्रॉप आफ्टर इट इज मैच्योर इज कॉल्ड हार्वेस्टिंग, राइट. नाउ हार्वेस्टिंग इन अवर कंट्री इज आइदर डन मैन्युअली बाय सिकल और अ मशीन कॉल्ड हार्वेस्टर. इन द हार्वेस्टेड क्रॉप द ग्रेन सीड्स आर टू बी सेपरेटेड फ्रॉम द शॉफ. शॉफ इज द कवर, दैट इज द जो सीड का छिलका होता है, दैट इज टू बी रिमूव्ड फ्रॉम द सीड, राइट. सो दैट इज रिमूव्ड बाय अ प्रोसेस कॉल्ड थ्रेशिंग. थ्रेशिंग मतलब इट इज बीटन, दैट हिप ऑफ क्रॉप, हिप ऑफ ग्रेन्स इज बीटन बाय समथिंग. बिकॉज ऑफ दैट वॉट हैपन्स इज द शॉफ गेट्स सेपरेटेड फ्रॉम द सीड. This is carried out with the help of a machine called combine. Nowadays, for this also, we have got different machines. This machine is called combine, which is in fact a harvester as well as a thresher. It does both the things. It also does threshing, or it also does harvesting. Harvesting is cutting of the crop and then threshing it. That is separating the crop, the seeds from the chaff. Right, both is being done. See, can you can see the picture of a combine into this. It is doing both the jobs, threshing and harvesting both. After harvesting, sometimes stubs are left in the field which are burned by farmers. Paheli is worried. She knows that it causes pollution. It may also catch fire and damage the crops lying in the fields. Farmers with small holdings of land do separation of grain and chaff by winnowing. You have already studied this in class 7. Now what is winnowing? Winnowing is dropping the seeds, the grains from a given height. Because of that, what happens is after threshing, the chaff has already got separated. The grain is heavier, so it falls down, and the chaff is lighter in weight, so it flies away from the seed, right? So this way we can separate the grain and the chaff. So that is called winnowing. Underline this point. Underline all these points. This is carried out with the help of this combined one. It is a combined harvester and thresher. Then further, winnowing is a process by which the seeds are separated from the chaff. Now this is a winnowing machine that you can see. It is also done physically by people. Winnowing machine is also doing the same thing, that the chaff and the seed is separated. Now let us read further. Harvest festivals. Now in India there are a lot of harvest festivals that we celebrate. After 3 or 4 months of hard work, there comes the day of harvest. The sight of golden fields of standing crop laden with grain fills the hearts of farmers with joy and a sense of well-being. The efforts of the past season have borne fruit, and it is time to relax and enjoy a little. The period of harvest is thus of great joy and happiness in all parts of India. Men and women celebrate it with great enthusiasm. Special festivals associated with the harvest season are Pongal, Baisakhi, Holi, Diwali, Navanya and Bihu. So these festivals are celebrated in different parts of India after the harvesting is done, harvesting of the crop is done, right? Now let us move on to storage. What is storage? Storage is the storage of these food grains into those gunny bags, which is available. Gunny bags yani jo गुन में मिलते हैं ना आपको बाहर मार्केट में, जब आप गेहूं खरीदते हो, तो दैट इज कॉल्ड स्टोरेज. दैट इज डन इन डिफरेंट स्टोर हाउसेस. स्टोरेज ऑफ प्रोड्यूस कैन इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट टास्क. इफ द हार्वेस्टेड ग्रेन्स आर टू बी केप्ट फॉर अ लॉन्गर टाइम, दे शुड बी सेफ फ्रॉम मॉइस्चर, इंसेक्ट्स, रैट्स एंड माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स, राइट. दे शुड बी केप्ट सेफ फ्रॉम ऑल दीज पेस्ट एंड माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स, अदरवाइज द ग्रेन्स विल बी डैमेज्ड. Harvested grains have more moisture. If freshly harvested grains or seeds are stored without drying, they may get spoiled or attacked by microorganisms, making them unfit for use for germination, right? They cannot even be used for germination, or else they are unfit for eating also. Hence, before storing them, the grains are properly dried in sun. The grains are properly dried in sun to reduce the moisture in them. Because of that, what happens is, due to reduction in the moisture, the grains become dry and they are not easily attackable by the microorganisms, moisture, insects or rats. These prevents the attack by insect pests, bacteria and fungi. Insect pests, bacteria and fungi also attack these because of the moisture inside the grains. If they are dried, they will not be attacked. I saw my mother putting some dried neem leaves in iron drum containing wheat. I wonder why. Now, घर पे भी हम लोग जब ग्रेन स्टोर करते हैं पूरे साल का ग्रेन हम ले लेते हैं, गेहूँ और चावल पूरे साल का एक साथ ही हम लोग भर देते हैं और बड़े बड़े जो ये कंटेनर्स होते हैं उसके अंदर हम लोग स्टोर करते हैं। तो उसको प्रोटेक्ट करने के लिए हम लोग कुछ चीज़ें लगाते हैं, जैसे कैस्टर ऑयल यानी दिवेल। कुछ ग्रेन्स को हम लोग दिवेल लगाते हैं टू प्रोटेक्ट देम फॉर अ लॉन्गर टाइम, मतलब वो पूरा साल उसमें चलते रहेगा, उसको कुछ भी डैमेज नहीं होगा, कोई भी पेस्ट अटैक नहीं करेंगे। या तो फिर दूसरे कुछ लोग उसके अंदर बोरिक एसिड पाउडर्स डालते हैं या बोरिक एसिड टैबलेट्स डाल के रखते हैं, या फिर जैसे इसमें दिया है नीम के लीव्स।